But all day, including the moment negotiations failed.
It was an emotional day from the beginning. 34-year-old Alexis Franco had been arrested in a domestic violence case 2 weeks ago, and things were apparently getting worse. This morning, Orlando SWAT team was called in when arrest warrants were issued for stalking, tampering with a witness, and violation of Franco's release.
And they brought a woman down the street here who was visibly upset. We kind of figured she was maybe connected with the person.
In fact, police say the couple had children in common, and he had threatened her and any officer who interfered.
Was it frightening?
Very, very frightening.
This neighbor had left to run errands early in the morning, but wasn't allowed back home.
Never heard that anything happened around here, and all of a sudden, all of this is scary.
For the longest time, police said they were having conversations with the man inside the house. They had hopes that it would end peacefully. Then, sounds started coming out from around the neighborhood. We couldn't quite tell at first whether it was gunfire or something else.
Police said it was decided to force Franco out with gas canisters, but while they were doing so, they heard a shot from inside. Alexis Franco had ended his life in a single shot.
In the end, people make choices, and he made a choice to end his life with a gunshot wound.
No one else in the neighborhood was hurt. The standoff ended and streets reopened 6 hours after it started. In Orlando, Orange County, Dave McDaniel, West 2 News.